The West Coast of Skye offers some of the best sea kayaking in the UK. However, such a trip requires good planning and weather. Camp spots and places to land are infrequent on this coast. Settled weather and swell are essential for a successful trip. The trip was researched and planned. A suitable weather window spotted. 8 days' gear was sorted out. And we were off. Initially, just Jeff and myself, with Will joining us on day three. It was a long drive up the Skye for an overnight camp spot at Harlosh. We had the stunning view of Loch Bracadale, but a very cold night in the bivvy bag. The next day, it was a short drive to the launch spot at Dunvegan for breakfast, before packing the boats, and then we were ready for the off. The plan for day one was to paddle round Dunvegan Head to camp at Meenish, a distance of around 12 miles. Very close to Dunvegan Head, conditions have picked up a bit. We've reached our planned stopover point, Meenish Pier. We've had permission to camp in the boatyard, giving us a bit of shelter from the cold wind. Sheltering from the wind and the cold.
Howling. Howling it.
And we're still here and it's dark o'clock and the wind's blowing stronger. And Jeff's still drinking his rum.
Our lads, they need a decent rum.
Yeah,
cheers, Bob.
Windy night in the tent.
A windy night.
The plan for day two was to paddle around the iconic Neist Point and onto Lorgill Bay, a distance of about 12 miles. Neist Point has a notorious reputation for confused, fierce sea conditions and complex tides, and is not a trip to attempt in bad conditions. Fortunately, the strong wind had subsided, swell conditions were low, so all we had to do was arrive at slack water for an uneventful rounding. However, the tides are complex round the point, with the eddy flow from Moon and Bay running at different times, colliding with the main flow at Neist Point. It took a long discussion before we agreed on a plan and the best time to arrive at Neist Point. That's Neist Point Lighthouse just come into view. We're just rounding Neist Point now. Everything's very calm. Neist Point must be sleeping. I think we got the timings just right. We are just round the point. There is some water movement coming from Moon and Bay, but only very slight. We've pulled into the north end of Moon and Bay for some lunch. What a super spot. This area has a prehistoric feeling about it. It's amazing. Day 3 was a big day. The plan was to paddle down to Harlosh, which promised to be a spectacular trip. We were then meeting up with Will, shuttling the car down to Elgol, and then late afternoon paddling onto Talisker Bay for the night's camp. That's about 20 miles of paddling and nearly 4 hours of driving, hence the early start. Thank you.
Thank you.